Hello to all of our viewers. I am Dr. Mandeep Singh, Senior Consultant, Sri Guru Har Krishan Sahab Hospital, Sohana, Mohali. I will be talking to you about a very important topic, that is hypertension, or as we know it as high blood pressure. So basically, I will try to make you aware about the causes of hypertension, the definition of hypertension, what are the risk factors for acquiring this disease, what are the complications that can happen to a patient with hypertension. And apart from that, what are the lifestyle measures that we can adopt so that we can avoid this disease. And apart from that, when and how to seek medical care when you have hypertension. And apart from that, something about treatment and other very useful things. So first of all, coming to the definition of hypertension. So basically, hypertension, as we know in layman language, it is high blood pressure. So what is blood pressure? Blood pressure is basically the pressure that is being exerted by the blood on our blood vessels. So we basically measure it as systolic and diastolic blood pressure. So there are two numbers. One is the upper number, which is the systolic blood pressure, and one is the lower number, which we call as diastolic blood pressure. So systolic blood pressure is basically the blood pressure when the heart is beating, and diastolic blood pressure is basically the blood pressure when the heart is resting between the beats. So both of these have their own implications in a patient with hypertension. So first of all, what is the normal range of blood pressure? Now the latest guidelines that we have, they say that the normal blood pressure, systolic or the upper blood pressure, varies between 100 to 130. And the normal blood pressure, lower blood pressure, diastolic is 60 to 80. So we have a stages of hypertension. Systolic between 130 to 140 is taken as pre-hypertension. 140 to 160 stage 1. 160 to 180 as stage 2. And above 180 we treat as hypertensive crisis. And similarly, diastolic pressure above 80 to 90 is pre-hypertension, 90 to 100 is stage 1 hypertension, 100 to 110 stage 2, and above 110 is crisis or emergency situation, as we can say. So basically these are the definition that we use to treat and manage the patient. And coming to Indian scenario, in India there is an upsurge in the patient with hypertension recently. And it is estimated that around 10 crore people are suffering from this disease. And only about 40% of the patient, they know that they are suffering from this disease. And out of them, only 37% people are seeking treatment. And out of which only 20% patients are having controlled blood pressure. So what is the reason for this upsurge of hypertension in India? Some of the factors are that raising socioeconomic conditions, urbanization, people are moving into the cities, lifestyles are changing. There is sedentary lifestyle, lack of physical activity, adoption of fast foods, then there is a lot of pollution, then use of tobacco, smoking, alcohol, and all of these things, and urbanization, all these things are bringing about a lot of stress in the life of people. So stress is another factor that is causing this raised blood pressure. So coming to the risk factors, who are the people who are more likely to develop this disease? So first of all is obesity or overweight. So whoever has a high, heavy weight, so such a patient can have an increased risk of getting hypertension. So second is sedentary lifestyle, people who don't exercise that much. And third is who take a lot of stress. Fourth is who take a lot of alcohol, who smoke a lot, take a lot of fast food. And there are other factors which we call as non-modifiable risk factor, which include increasing age. As age increases, there is increased risk of hypertension. Then there is genetic factors, hereditary. If your father or mother or your sibling, brother, sister have hypertension, you are more likely to get the disease. So all this that I have mentioned just now, these are the sort of people that need to monitor their blood pressure regularly. So risk factors apart, what are the signs and symptoms of hypertension? We say this is a very negative word, but we say that it's a silent killer. So basically, most of the people, they don't have any signs and symptoms. So patient come to us in the clinic and they say blood pressure 160, 90, they don't have any problem with. But basically, it is a slow damager. So your heart and your blood vessels, they are working against such high blood pressure, and slowly they are sustaining damage. There is damage to the heart slowly. The heart can increase in size. So as soon as your age progresses, the function of the heart can go down, and such a person can later on go on to develop heart failure, or even, as you say, heart attack or MI, myocardial infarction. There is increased risk. Apart from that, your blood pressure is also high, so the blood vessels are continuously under stress. So there is increased deposition of cholesterol in the arteries, which causes the narrowing of the arteries, and in such a scenario, there can be heart attack, or there can be increased risk of stroke, or as we say, paralysis in common language. And apart from that, also there is later on, as the age progresses, there is early onset of memory loss, which we call as dementia in such a patient. And there are other organ damages that are happening due to this. Vision loss is a very common problem due to retinopathy. Then the patient can develop chronic kidney disease. Slowly kidneys can also get damaged. And then there is increased risk of heart arrhythmias. Your beat can be missing beats, or patient says, I have palpitation, dhadkan mehsoos hota hai. You can have vertigo, chakkar aana. These all symptoms, the patient can have all these symptoms. So these are the long-term effects of hypertension. So we need to stress on this. And apart from that, the thing is, how do you monitor? When you have all these risk factors, there is very important way. Home monitoring of BP is recommended, because sometimes when patient comes to clinic under anxiety and all, he can have or she can have a high blood pressure reading. So we do not treat it as hypertension. We have to monitor the patient at home. So home monitoring is advisable. But basic thing is, how do you monitor at home? That is very important. So there are some prerequisites that you need to do. Before monitoring blood pressure, there are some things that needed to be done. So these are that at least you should be resting for at least half an hour before taking your blood pressure. And you should refrain from taking coffee, tea, alcohol, smoke. These all things should be avoided at least half an hour prior to taking blood pressure. And you should be sitting for 5 minutes, relaxing on chair. And the arm, left and right arm, both sides, you should check your blood pressure. And whatever the reading comes, you should take an average of both the readings. And reading should be taken twice, immediately and 2 minutes later. And all these readings, you should take an average of these readings, and that is your blood pressure. And apart from that, the blood pressure cuff should be midway between the elbow and the shoulder. And another thing is that your arm should be resting on the table comfortably, and you should not talk while your blood pressure is being taken. So all these factors considered, and after that, if there is still three or more readings of high blood pressure, so then you should take a medical opinion. And medical opinion, then we have two things that are important. First and foremost is the dietary management of the patient. So dietary management includes many things. First of all is lifestyle modifications. So lifestyle modifications include, first and foremost is the weight loss. It is the most important thing. If you lose your weight by 10%, you can decrease your systolic blood pressure by 10 millimeter. So weight loss is first and foremost. Second is decrease in salt intake. And third is take more of potassium in your diet. And potassium, that diet includes banana and coconut water. All these things contain a lot of potassium, and it can help you decrease your blood pressure. Third is, if you are a smoker, you have to stop smoking. Cessation, total cessation of smoking is required. Fourth is, alcohol consumption has to be cut down or entirely stopped. And apart from that, at least 30 minutes of aerobic exercise has to be done daily. Aerobic exercise means jogging, brisk walking, cycling, and all these things you can do half an hour a day, so that you lose your weight and blood pressure reduction occurs naturally. So these lifestyle measures are very important. So, but even after adoption of lifestyle changes, If your blood pressure still remains on the higher side, then we have to put you on some medications so that long-term complications are prevented. So coming to the end of this talk, the most important thing you need to understand is that hypertension is a lifelong disease. You need to monitor your blood pressure if you are having any risk factors, as I explained. And lifestyle changes are first and foremost and very important. And if you have hypertension, you need to monitor your blood pressure regularly and need to visit your physician or doctor on regular intervals and decrease your level of stress and take proper dietary measures, exercise. And to decrease your level of stress, you can adopt a few measures like deep breathing exercises, meditation and yoga. All these things are very helpful apart from taking medication. So I hope these things are helpful to you. And I am always available for a medical advice at SGHS Sohana Hospital. And thank you very much.